Today is a hip throw or a бедро. Бросок через бедро in Russian. Start the lesson. The hip throw is a classic of the wrestling art. It's a powerful and relatively simple technique which children learn one of the first, but which you can see at the final bouts of the World Championships. This throw engages the strongest muscles and use the weight of the couple of the opponent's bodies. Let's see how it's work. Let's introduce couple of notations. It will muscle tension zone. It will mean muscle relax. So, let's start. We will learn it from two practical points. The throw is applied from the main grip, upper belt grip. The opponent is standing in the frontal position or is slightly bended to you. The second initial grip is made with a sleeve or a lapel by other hand, and it's desirable that your second hand will be used too. But second arm may be free also. The grip can be performed both across the shoulder of the same name and across the shoulder with different names. I recommend the upper belt grip because it's executed correctly, does not allow the opponent to straighten up and counterattack you with the body throw. So, in this stage, relax the shoulder of the arm that keeps the belt throw in this point. Relax here. Relax here. This point is in tension position. You must make 180 degrees turn of your low back as quickly as possible without any premotion. Pay attention that in the result of your turn shall be flying up your opponent's. His center of gravity shall be above your low back. And very important, pay attention that your feet have to stay on the line between his feet and his center of gravity correctly above your line between your feet. Now, on the next stage, we powerfully straighten our legs. Having completed the hip lift, move your body forward, forcing the opponent to follow you, breaking his balance. As a result, he should learn his body tightly on your back. Your center of gravity must be lower than his center of gravity, and your body should block the opponent's way forward to prevent the opponent escape from your back. At this stage, at the expense of leg straightening and body bending, the opponent is finally taken off the mat. Depending on how you're going to throw, with a fall down or from standing position, the vector of the pulling should be directed by shoulder rotation to the steep arch or the sloping one, like this or like this. The work is done. In case it necessary, continue fighting in the ground position and switch to the hold down or arm lock. Please pay attention that the throw is divided into the phases for training purposes only. In the real fight, the throw is performed together as a single movement without any stops. But let's go back to the first phase of the throw once again. This is the most important moment. Please note that as a result of your turn, the opponent must either flying up from the mat or stand on his toes. Only in this case we can say that start of the throw is successful. Only after that we can start rotating him around the center of gravity and he will not be able to counterattack us. If you have completed the turn and the opponent remains standing on the two legs, then you are very much at risk. An experienced opponent, and in this case, will not give himself throw. Any technique is based on the special physical conditions of the fighter. Therefore, traditionally, when we teach technique, we also give special exercises for develop the qualities required in this particular throw. In order to find necessary exercises, we as always break the throw into separate movements and simulate them in the burdened conditions. First useful exercise is a shoulder rotation with a rubber harness. Bendings for the stomach muscles we needed in the throw. Throw imitation with a rubber harness. With the dummy throws, we need to learn relaxed shoulder and very quick rotate our low back. Very same exercises, but with a traditional dummy. As quick as possible, we need to rotate our low back and work with our shoulders. Somersault, forward somersault, very good for jump, for forward rotation. Quarter seats with a partner, with some other weights for the legs, good legs conditions. It's very useful for this throw. And pulling some barbells, some weights to the chin. No matter how well we do this throw, something can always go wrong. We must be ready to switch to another technique to develop the attack. Depending on how the opponent reacts, we can continue the attack with a zashagni deep step. Our opponent rotates his low back towards the throw and we can perform zashagni. We can perform hook inside if he just down his center of gravity, or a sweep of the feet like this. We can switch to the gadavle, very powerful throw, very famous throw from the Georgian wrestling, chedaoba. Or if our opponent try go away from our hip, we can use our leg for подхват, uchimata in Japan terminology, one leg or a two leg подхват like this. You can learn how to perform these additional techniques from the further lessons of our course. Good luck!